Weinstein. How's the new job up in Canada?
Oh, hey, Sid. I'm back in the game.
Great. I knew you'd pull yourself together. Listen, the deceased family is really hounding
her,
you.
Her name was Karen.
Right. Of course. Family's attorneys are hounding me about these late payments. They're still waiting for that check.
Listen, Sid, I'm expecting a big bonus. I mean, I just keep this account from jumping ship and...
These people don't want to hear more excuses, Joe. I've got to tell them something. When are you going to have the next 15 grand?
Just buy me some time, okay?
Look, we can't let this get back to the judge. That's when it's going to get ugly. You hear what I'm saying?
Yeah. Thanks, Sid.
You know, Joe, Montreal's a great place to start over.
Well, I'm still in a little readjustment mode, but I'm feeling a lot better.
Good, good. Put all that other stuff behind you.
You know what, Paul? I had it all once, and I'll have it all again.
We need a guy like you. Since Hunter died, this agency's been going south faster than Montreal drag queens in December.
You know, Paul, I really missed you.
Watch yourself.
Oh. Ouch.
Sorry.
My fault.
Juliet, this is Joe Goodis. Joe, Juliet Laurier, assistant to our senior VP. Joe has taken over the Wilson account.
Good luck.
You sure I can't help you with that?
I don't think so.
She's a doll, but she's not your type. She was Hunter's personal assistant.
How was the move?
Easy. All I had to move was myself.
They took everything, huh?
Yep. But they let me keep my best suit.
You can't even imagine what you've been through.
Let's just keep all this between us, okay?
Like a clam. Lily Hunter's office. Mrs. Hunter, to us peons. Started out the epitome of a trophy wife. Then hubby dies. Now she's coming in every day like clockwork, just to show us all she's in charge. Problem is, she knows zip about running an agency. All she knows how to do is own things.
Hey, it's Billy the Kid. This is Joe. He's new here.
Hey, Billy. Exactly the warm and cuddly type, is he?
I feel sorry for him. His mother treats him like a pet monkey, hardly lets him out of her sight.
A bit overprotective?
Like I said, all she knows how to do is own things.
How did Mr. Hunter go, anyway?
Heart. At least that's what they told us.
Why, is there a question?
Mr. Hunter had more money than God. Now Lily's got it. You make the call.
I see you haven't lost your wicked imagination.
I am the creative director. A wicked imagination's what I get paid for. And meagerly, I might add. Now, you can check out the equipment whenever you want, which I've been known to do on occasion.
Excuse me. Do you know a good place for sushi around here?
Tokyo. Down the block to your left. Can't miss it.
Thanks. I appreciate it.
Oh, Billy! Are you okay? Are you all right? Sweetheart, are you okay?
Yeah, I'm okay.
You parked too far from the curb. Idiot.
It's okay.
It's okay? All right, come on.
Good morning, Mrs. Hunter.
Do I know you?
No, I'm Joe Goodis. I just started working for you this week. And, well, I really like working here.
Isn't that nice?
Here. You okay, Billy?
He'll be fine.
With FDA approval, Mr. Wilson, Melaton can tap $40 million coming out of the gate.
Good work, Joe. Very, very good work.
Thank you, sir.
Merci, monsieur.
Why are you looking at me like that?
See, first I sketch it, and then I paint it. You know. Have you ever been to the islands?
I've never been anywhere.
Well, there's this beautiful island down the Caribbean, and I put a down payment on a small hotel down there right on the beach. I mean, it's really beautiful. And once I get enough money together, I'm gonna renovate and live there.
It's a beautiful dream.
Oh, no, it's not a dream. It's not. It's gonna happen. You see, there's two kinds of people in this world. Winners and losers. The difference is, losers want things, and winners get what they want.
I've heard of this island. Turks and Caicos?
How did you know the name of it?
Paul told me.
What else did Paul tell you?
Not much. What's wrong?
Nothing. I just don't like when people talk about me, that's all.
He didn't say anything bad. Why? Do you have secrets? We all have secrets.
I guess I shouldn't have done that.
But you did.
Yeah.
Sorry, sir. Your card was denied.
Denied? Oh, they must have not got my last payment. I'll take care of this.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Wilson's pulling out.
What? They were drooling over that new campaign.
Hunter and Wilson went back a long way. We knew keeping the account wouldn't be easy.
So what you're saying is I never had a chance.
Look, Joe, don't take it personally, okay? It's not your fault. Anyways, you still have the McCormick account.
Yeah.
These are difficult days for Hunter Advertising. I had hoped to carry on and make this company my husband's enduring legacy. However, since his death, it seems that business has been on a downward spiral. I can cut costs. I can downsize. I can find ways of improving the balance sheets to a degree. But I cannot, and I will not, keep pouring my money into a losing proposition. So the bottom line is this. Either your performance improves dramatically over the next quarter, or I will be forced to close the agency.
What's the matter?
She's letting me go. I've got 1 month. Do you know how hard I've worked? Overtime, weekends. It's not fair.
It's never fair.
I was with Mr. Hunter right until the end. He counted on me for everything.
Look, Juliet, it's not the only job in the world.
I don't want another job. You don't know the kind of mess I'm in. I did so much for her. And this is how she repays me.
Hey, look. Don't let it get to you. Find a way to get to that island.
Yes. Why should Mrs. Hunter care? She has her millions. All we have is dreams. I'm tired of living dreams. You know what we should do, don't you?
What?
We should kidnap Billy.
Yeah, right.
I'm serious. Mrs. Hunter has 20 million easy. She gives us 2, she has 18 left. Which is plenty. Besides, no one gets hurt.
Somebody always gets hurt.
So, you're okay with working 9 to 5 the rest of your life? Retire when you're too old to enjoy it?
No, I didn't say that.
I want to sit with my feet in warm sand. I want to go to bed late and wake up whenever I feel like it. And I want you, Joe. I want us to be together. No pressure, no worries. Living every day in our own little paradise. I just want us to get what we deserve. I love you, Joe.
Yeah, but
kidnapping. I mean, isn't that going a little too far?
Why? We just have to do it smart. Find the right moment. Hold him for a couple days.
Stop talking about it.
I just want us to be happy. That's all.
Joe Goodis.
Hey, Joe, it's Sid Feinstein. Think you know why I'm calling.
Right. The payment.
Yeah, the payment. Listen, it's more serious than that. Now, the family's attorneys have asked the court to find you in default.
I haven't missed one yet.
Your last check bounced. You are over a month late on this one. If they don't see something right away, they're going to file a motion to enforce.
Come on, Sid. Keep the bloodhounds away for a couple more weeks. I ran into some bad luck, but I'm working on something new. I mean, I'll have the money. Sid?
Yeah. I'll see what I can do. I may be able to buy you another week, but that's it.
Right. I hear you.
Lawsuit. I was in a car accident, and my girlfriend was killed. Then her parents sued me for wrongful death, and they won. And now I'm here.
I'm
much, sir.
Can I get a quick shine?
One moment, sir. Quick phone call. Hi, honey. Can you pick me up in half an hour? Thanks.
I thought you didn't smoke.
Former bad habit. Shopping every day. Rough life.
I could deal with that.
Is this kid ever alone? I mean...
He will be. And that's when we'll take him. It's just over there.
Wow. Talk about the middle of nowhere.
Thank you.
This is gonna scare him to death.
There's a window.
Yeah, a window.
Have a seat. Be a good boy.
What if he's claustrophobic?
Well, you relax. It's not gonna cure him. Ever sleep on a bed of 2 million cash?
This place is pretty grim.
Come on. It's fantastic. He can scream as loud as he wants. Nobody will hear. Remind me to turn off the sound next time. Background noises could give us away.
You know, she'd probably can his ass if she knew he was out eating hot dogs.
The piano teacher's house. It's perfect.
No, it's not perfect. Look at all the houses back there. One person looks out the window.
It's the only time he's alone.
What's up with Mrs. Hunter anyway? I mean, I know the company's not doing well, but that attitude.
She's always been like that, even when Hunter was alive.
It's like she's got permanent PMS.
Yeah. I figured she'd lighten up a little bit after he died. Couldn't have been much fun for her.
Why do you say that?
Oh, Joey, Joey, Joe. You're so naive. Lily likes girls.
Well, how do you know?
Takes one to know one.
Listen. Why don't you just give me a minute, okay?
Mrs. Hunter is leaving for Europe next Monday. I just found out. She might be gone for months. It has to be this Saturday.
It's too soon.
The piano teacher's house.
We haven't even got a plan yet.
We still have a few days. It's our only chance.
Are you sure you're gonna be all right?
I'll be fine.
All right, I gotta go. Mm.
music!
Hello, Emily.
Open it! Open it! Come on! Move over, I'm driving.
What happened?
The chauffeur was there.
Did he see you?
I don't think so. Let's just get out of here. Son.
Who is this?
Listen, if you do exactly what we say, nothing will happen to him.
What is this, some kind of prank?
No, this is no prank, Mrs. Hunter. Listen to me.
No, no, he's gonna be home any minute. He went to his piano lesson. He's gonna be home any minute.
Tomorrow, you get proof that he's alive and instructions where to drop off the money.
Is he okay?
Yes, he's fine. He'll be fine. Just do what we tell you.
And no cops, got it?
Hello? Hello?
I think he's moving around.
Do it again.
Do it again.
Thank you.
him sleep.
Why are we stopping?
He has tape across his mouth. He's wearing a blindfold and he's not moving.
Yeah?
We're not going to get anything if she thinks the kid's already dead. Just get him to move.
Yeah, get him to move.
You'd make a lousy psychologist.
Look, why don't we just write on the board, he's only playing dead?
Poke him with this.
I can't do that.
Fine, I'll do it.
Look, let's not make it any worse on him.
He's playing with us, Joe.
This isn't going like we planned.
The sooner we get him on tape, the sooner we get our money.
Listen, don't be scared. I'm just gonna poke you with a little stick. I just want you to move. All right? I promise I'm not gonna hurt you. I promise.
Ah!
We have to get rid of that stuff.
I'll take the camcorder back in the morning.
We can just trash the rest.
You can do that. I wonder how he's doing.
He'll be fine. Kids are tough.
Yeah, but I just hope we're not screwing up his head for life.
None of us had perfect childhoods. We all have to work through something.
Yeah. But how many of us get kidnapped?
He'll be home in a couple of days. And in a few years, he won't even remember this. You'll make a great dad someday.
Good morning.
I brought us some breakfast. How do you sleep?
Not well.
Poor Joe. I slept like a baby. Come on. Have something to eat.
I'm not very hungry. Aren't you forgetting something?
Look at these shoes. I love these shoes. I bet they're expensive. Why do I care? We're gonna be millionaires.
Doesn't it bother you? I mean, at all, what we did?
Don't burst my bubble. I'm shopping here.
Look at me. Look at me. We kidnapped somebody's child. How can you not think about that? How?
Why are you being like this? You think I don't have feelings? You think this is easy for me?
I didn't say that.
It breaks my heart to think of him. It's dark. He's alone. I feel what his mother must be going through. I'm a woman.
You're not a mother.
What are you saying?
Look, look, we've both been under a lot of stress. Neither of us thought it'd be this hard.
As long as we don't hurt him, it'll be just like we said. And we get $2 million. Right, Joe?
Right. Right. Listen, I'm gonna go feed the kid. You stay here.
Joe, by this time next week, we'll be in paradise.
Yeah. Listen, I'm gonna take the tape off, but you gotta promise me you're not gonna scream. Because even if you do, no one's gonna hear you. The only thing that's gonna happen is you'll upset me, okay? So just promise me you'll be quiet. All right, Billy? Listen, I brought you something to make you feel better. Here you go. Open your mouth. It's just cold medicine. It's okay. It wasn't that bad, was it? Here. I got you some food. You must be starving. I love oatmeal when I was your age. Nah, I'm lying. My mom made me eat it in the morning, or she wouldn't let me go out of the house. And now when I eat it, it kind of reminds me of being a kid in a good way. Milk, a little brown sugar, and voila. Here, let me wipe your nose first. There you go. Okay. I'll try some first, all right? Oh, it's not bad. Here. Just try a little bit. It's really good. Pretty good, huh? I brought plenty more. You can eat all you want. Is it too hot? Please don't cry. You're gonna be home before you know it. What? We forgot something.
What?
How does he go to the bathroom?
He wears his pants? No big deal. We'll just get him some new ones. Here. This will cheer you up. Open it. I know. You told me not to buy anything, but you were so depressed this morning. I had to do something.
This must have cost $5,000.
So? That's cheap.
How'd you pay for it?
I use your credit card.
You what?
I'll pay you back. You can't live in paradise without a waterproof watch.
Mrs. Hunter, the video showing that your son is alive will be taped to the ceiling of that phone booth. Now listen very carefully.
At the airport, pull up to the entrance marked departures. Once you're inside, you'll see four public phones on the wall facing you.
Take the bag over to the phone furthest to the left.
Place the bag underneath that phone.
Pretend to make a phone call.
then turn around, leave the terminal, and drive away.
Okay, I'll be there. I'll be there. But if you hurt him, I swear to God, I'll spend every dime I have to track you down. Do you hear me?
Doing a little homework?
Huh? Oh. I just used it to make a video resume.
Really? Who did the taping?
I just put it on auto. Huh.
Well, I guess it is getting time to send out the old resume, huh? This place is starting to feel like the Titanic.
Yeah, and only so many lifeboats.
Oh, you know the rule. Women and children first. Oh, by the way, someone vandalized Mrs. Hunter's office. Smashed the furniture, spray painted the walls. Natives are getting restless.
Juliet, I'd like to speak to you in my office, now.
Hey. What was that all about?
You look so nervous.
I am nervous. I mean, Mrs. Hunter walked straight up to you. I mean, what did she want?
She asked me to stay on for an extra week.
That's it?
Oh, she asked if I knew who trashed her office.
She didn't ask anything about Billy.
Not a word.
But that look on her face, it was like she suspected you.
Calm down. You give yourself a heart attack.
I'm a mess.
Come on. Nobody knows a thing.
Who are those guys?
I don't know. Maybe they're clients?
They look like cops.
Joe,
don't be so paranoid.
Paranoid.
Not to mention loaded.
You think I got a chance?
She called the cops.
Would you relax? I told you why you were there.
The vandalism? I mean, you believe that?
Yes, I do.
Something doesn't feel right.
Okay, I've got an idea. We can have a signal. If she called the cops, we'll see them. We stop, we walk away, Forget about the money, forget about everything.
The duffel bag is right below the phone. Reach down and you'll touch it. Got it. Okay, do your thing.
Hi.
He's on his way. Keep your eye on me.
It's gonna work, Joe.
Choice do we have?
We have choices.
Name some. Name one.
You could cut off one of Billy's fingers and send it to her in a box.
Don't even.
We can't give up now.
It would be suicide to go on.
We got away. We're safe. Billy's safe. We just have to think of a new plan.
That was the plan. We are out of plans.
You have no idea where I'm coming from.
What do you mean?
How did you grow up? Mom? Dad? Nice home, nice neighborhood, nice friends. Well, I had no mom, no dad, no home. I was living on the streets before I could spell my name. One day I realized that I did have a choice. I talked my way into some small paying jobs, took night classes, made myself a future. I didn't want to tell you. I wanted to leave the past behind. But now, I feel I'm sliding back. And if I don't do something, I'll get sucked down again. Next time, maybe, I won't be strong enough to climb up. Don't let that happen to me, Joe. I never want to go back there.
We'll figure something out, okay?
Thank you.
Are you gonna kill me?
No. Here. I brought you some new pants. I'm gonna untie you now. I promise you're gonna be good, okay? There. Does that feel better? There. Here you go. All right.
Can I hold the cat? I want to see my mom.
asking everybody to take one? Mm-hmm.
That's right. It's just routine procedure.
Billy the Kid got kidnapped.
What?
That's the word. Cops are here to polygraph all the employees.
They can't do that.
They're asking us to volunteer. Half today, half tomorrow. Anyone refuses, they'll be all over them. What's wrong?
Nothing. I've just never taken a lie detector test before.
Shouldn't be anything to worry about. Unless, of course, you don't have anything to hide, do you?
Like what?
Look, Joe, I was the guy who brought you in here. I feel responsible.
I'm a big boy, Paul. I knew what I was getting into.
Not when it comes to this girl.
What girl?
Oh, come on, Joe. You don't know her like I do. You're in over your head.
Don't worry about me.
She was having an affair with Mr. Hunter.
That's not against the law.
She was after his money, and she would have done anything to get it.
So what are you saying? She killed him?
I am saying that when he died, Lily got the money, and Juliet was left in the cold. And that's when you came in. I don't want to see you get hurt, Joe. We'll pick this up later.
I'm next on the polygraph.
Oh, God.
We can pass it. People have done it before.
Juliet, this is not a game.
Juliet Laurier, please call reception.
Wish me luck. Don't you know, it's not nice to talk behind people's backs.
Listening at doors now, are we?
You've had a problem with me since the day I got here.
I know your kind.
And what kind is that? I know how things must look, but you should really know the truth.
What about, who kidnapped Billy?
About me and Joe.
Please.
You don't understand. I really love him.
Like you did Mr. Hunter. Cops are waiting for me. You're not gonna get away with this. I won't let Joe take the fall for you.
What took you so long?
Get a grip, Joe.
What happened with the polygraph?
I passed.
What? How?
Wasn't that hard. I just made my mind go blank, but they didn't have a clue. How many seconds have you had? Will you stop worrying? They've got nothing.
Paul! Paul knows about us.
Don't worry about Paul.
I am worried about Paul. What if Paul says something in this polygraph test?
Paul is not going to be taking any polygraph tests.
What? What'd you do?
Let's just say Paul got a little too close to the edge. He confronted me, Joe. He said he was going to tell the cops everything. He wasn't your friend. It's gonna be okay. The police will think it was a suicide.
No one was supposed to get hurt. No one was supposed to get hurt.
It was him or us, Joe. I did what had to be done. Where are you going? You shouldn't have done that.
I'm sorry.
Oh, what is the matter with you? I was gonna take you home. I saw my face.
And?
If I take him home, he knows me. That's it. It's over.
It is.
What else can I do, huh? I mean, kill him? Killing him would be okay with you, wouldn't it?
Do you remember what you told me? Two kinds of people. Winners and losers. Winners get what they want. That's what you told me. And I believed you. He doesn't have to suffer. You could do it quick. Put your hands around his neck, crush his windpipe, It'd be over in 2 minutes.
I can't kill him.
Okay. I'll do it. Can't be that hard. I'll put sleeping pills in his milk, wait till he's asleep, then cut open his wrist.
No, wait. I'll give you enough time to get away. I mean, you got a couple $100 to get across the border. You go to that island.
I thought you loved me.
We made a mistake. We were wrong.
Stop it. Don't say it anymore. I'm going to our island, Joe. Nothing can stop me. You're the one making a mistake. Goodbye, Joe.
Put your seatbelt on. Mistakes, Billy. And I don't expect you to forgive me. I just hope this doesn't screw you up for the rest of your life. Cause you're a good kid.
I don't hate you.
You made the right choice. Thank you, Mr. Goodis.
Billy?
Mom!
Oh, baby.
Freeze. You're under arrest for the kidnapping of William S. Hunter. Come on.
Let's go. All right, down. Get down. Get down.
Thank you.
found the rest of the rope, the tape, the chloroform, and the surveillance videos at Paul's apartment. The cops figure he panicked at having to take a lie detector test, did a swan dive because he couldn't handle the idea of getting caught.
While I was giving her time to get away, she planted all that stuff at his place. What did she say to the police?
Here's her statement.
I overheard Joe and Paul discussing Billy in a way that made it clear they were the kidnappers. After work, I confronted Joe and begged him to bring Billy home. First, it was Mr. Hunter. Now it's Mrs. Hunter. That was just a short detour in between.
The police know Paul was the one who brought you into the agency. You guys were old friends. He was up to his eyeballs in debt. And you couldn't have done it alone.
I didn't.
There's no evidence, no trail. She didn't leave a single crumb behind.
Two kinds of people in this world. Winners and losers.
Billy! Come on, we're gonna be late for the airplane. Are we ready? After all you've been through, you need this vacation. Oh, I forgot my medication. Well, Billy, a few hours from now, we'll be in paradise.
Somebody sent this to you. No name, no return address. We opened it.